Sapphire 2025.5 includes some exciting new enhancements to the preset browser, to the effect builder, and to the lens flare editor, as well, of course, as a range of new exciting presets. Let's take a quick look. Starting here in the preset browser, the layout has been optimized with the thumbnails over on the left and preview top right and the information on the bottom right. And I can change the size of these panels so I can see more or less thumbs and give myself more space over on the right here. Over here in the thumbnails, we actually are on the new tab here. Notice we have these new icons for the different categories. And these are all of the new presets that ship with Sapphire 2025.5. You'll notice there's a few clocks in here. I actually used a clock with an alpha channel because I wanted to showcase some of these great new infinite zoom presets that have been included. Some really fun and useful ones there. But definitely go out and check all of the new presets. Now, when you move your cursor over a preset, you will see some information about that preset. And this has changed a little bit because now you only see the top level information. We kept it a little cleaner, a little more simple. But if you do want to have the rest of the information, you can come up to the edit menu and choose browser settings. And in here, you'll find preset tooltips. And you can see mine is set to show and simplified by default. Now, if I deselect simplified and click OK, now when I roll over, you can see that we get more information. And if you don't want to see that, once again, just come up to browser settings and you can either turn that off completely or you can actually have it only appear when you hold down the shift key. So now when I move over a thumb, I can just hold down shift to only show the tooltips when I want to. Now, of course, the preset browser is all about finding great presets quickly so that you can speed up your workflow. And we've actually made that even easier and faster by updating the way you search for presets. Let's do a quick test. If I click up here in Search Presets, what you'll see is the filter menu is now integrated. And here you can choose from any of the tags that have been saved when presets were saved. What I'm going to do is do a global search just by typing in, say, the word red. And when I say global search, what's happening is that Sapphire is populating the search with anything that it found with the letters R-E-D. So not necessarily just in the tag, but it could be in the name of the preset, anywhere where it sees those letters. And you can see there's 865 results. If I click again, I can once again open up the filter menu and choose red. And now that will only find the presets that are tagged with red, 172 results. Let's add something. Let's add glowing. And that just happens to be another tag. So I'll add the tag there. So now we're refining it. Let's add abstract. And we'll just add that tag there. So now we've really refined the search. But what if you want to go back to, say, just red? What you can do is hold down the Option or Alt key, click on red, and that closes the other ones, which is really handy. And you can also add to the search by clicking on these options down here. Tags, plugin, or author. And I'm going to add to this green. So there's red and green. I'm going to add glowing. If I want to remove those and only add dark, down here I can hold down the Alt or Option key as well. And now I'm only seeing the dark presets or the presets with dark in the tag. And you can also, as I mentioned, search by author as well. So there's all of Alan's presets. And I actually like to search for my own presets. Obviously, I've made a lot of presets for Sapphire. And it's a quick way for me to find the things that I've created as well. If you don't want to see the filter menu, there's a few options for that. If you go to browser settings, here you can see add filter window. It's set to show by default. And you can also show the counts. So I'll just turn that on and we can take a look at that. So if I click, now you can see the count number for each tag. So you may prefer to be able to see that. Come back to browser settings again. And I'm going to turn off show counts and I'm going to turn on hold shift to show and actually turn that off for preset tooltips. And now I have to hold shift in order to be able to see that filter menu. So there's a few different options for you there for how that filter menu shows or doesn't show. With the preview, you can now, if I just zoom right out, you can now double click and that will fit that to the view. You can see it's 112. I just zoom out again. And if I hold down the Alt key, that will zoom to fit in the area of my cursor to 100%. So that's really handy as well. there's a new custom preset tab. And here I've got one custom preset. Notice how it has a little pencil icon, so it's much easier to find your own custom presets. There's also an icon for presets that use Mocha splines. If I type in Mocha, I can find the presets that way, or I can choose has Mocha in the tags. And you can see there's a small M icon to indicate that these have Mocha splines embedded. Okay, so now let's jump across to Sapphire Effect Builder and take a look at what's new there too. And Sapphire Effect Builder has also had some interface changes. You can see it's a lot darker. And also there's colorful new icons over here in the effect categories. If I hold down shift and say click on lighting, that will twirl open all of the categories so you can see all of their effects. And once again, clicking on the name of the category with shift held down will toggle them all closed, which is very handy. Down here in the workspace, you can see that the nodes also display the icons. This makes them a little bit easier to distinguish now. And you may also notice that you can see the custom name, which you can change over here in the selection parameters, and also the name of the node now. So sometimes when you change that in previous versions, you could, especially when you haven't got the icon, you could forget what effect that actually was until you looked over here on the right. So a little bit more discoverable now. Now, I'm using the right mouse button just to pan around here, and also the mouse wheel, which is the way I normally work. But you can actually now double click to show the entire hierarchy, which is handy. And if I roll in again and hold down the Option or Alt key and double click, that will zoom to 100%. And also here, if I hold down the Alt key, it will also zoom to 100% to where the cursor is. So it's now much easier to navigate, especially with these really big effects. Keep in mind also that you can view this in a vertical window layout, and that's really perfect for these long, long effects. Now, while we're in the workspace, another great feature which is saving me a lot of time is the new option for when a node is disconnected. Watch what happens if I just move over here and just disconnect this. Everything that is before quad tone is now red. So that shows that there's a disconnection right here. So a visual clue now as to what is not connected. And that can really save you time, especially when nodes are laid on top of each other, because it's really difficult to tell what's connected and what's disconnected. But now with the red, it makes it much easier. Selection parameters have received a minor UI tweak. And I just want to point out, if you haven't already checked it out, be sure to check out parameter linking, where you can make one parameter a driver and then choose a different parameter, and you can have that driven. A really useful tool and something you should definitely check out. The last thing I want to point out in here is over here in the preview. Once again, if I just zoom right out, I can double click to fit that to the view, or I can alt double click to zoom that up to 100%. So very welcome user enhancement there. Sapphire Lens Flare Designer also has the updated UI. Overall, the functionality is the same. There's one small change down here with gamma and brightness. If you're previewing your flares and you've adjusted these values, you can actually just come and click on the word gamma and brightness just to change those back to their default settings. And also, of course, come over to the new tab and explore the great new lens flare presets. All right, so that's just a short look at some of the new enhancements in Sapphire 2025.5. To learn more or to download a trial version, visit boriseffects.com.